farmers. But I think it's very, very important to create next generation of job givers. And we in the state of Andhra Pradesh believe that innovation is a way of life. It should become part of our society. You know, in alignment with Government of India policies, we have actually created an innovation society. We are doing hackathons on a monthly basis, and we'd like to invite HCL to join us in this amazing journey. We believe that there's amazing energy, amazing ideas in the youth in India, and in particular in Andhra Pradesh. It's very, very important to harness these ideas, to actually fund them in the right manner, to give them the right mentoring, to ensure that the next, you know, multi-billion dollar companies actually come from India. You know, in the state of Andhra Pradesh, we are looking at not just being number one in ease of doing business within the country, but how do we be distant number one? You know, in 2015, we were number two. In 2016, we were number one. And in 2017-18, we are also number one. But Mr. Naidu is quite clear that we should benchmark ourselves with countries like Singapore, Finland, the US, and actually strive to be among the top five on this planet. Babu Garu, who's here, you know, we keep joking with him that it's like he's our master, and we get a report card from him. So it's like a teacher who gives a report card for us, and our parent is Mr. Naidu. This is because we actually have a real-time governance center, and it's one of its kind on this planet. And very many marquee investments in the state actually get reviewed by the real-time governance. And I keep jokingly saying that the single largest FDI investment in Indian history actually came to Andhra Pradesh, and that was Kia. I doubt whether the CEO of Kia monitors the project so much, but real-time governance center actually monitors the project and gives a report to the Honorable Chief Minister. And I'm pretty certain that HCL will also be monitored by the real-time governance center. And if there's any delay, I'll definitely call out to Karta, Karma and Kriya Pavanji here, because who's been behind my back to get this project going. And you know, we'll make sure that this journey will be an amazing journey. Apart from that, I'd like to congratulate HCL. I'd like to thank them. I think it's very, very important that the first company takes the leap of faith in investing in the state of Andhra Pradesh. And I'm really excited that, you know, HCL took that. I couldn't have asked for a better partner. And I was just sharing it with Roshini that Nadarji was so excited about this campus, because I have not had interaction with him ever, and this was the first time I was meeting him. The entire campus comes out of a painting he has. The entire design comes out of a painting. And the passion with which he showed this campus to the Honorable Chief Minister and me personally was just amazing. And I'm sure that this passion will translate into execution with the amazing team he has and the team that he has built over his amazing journey, his career. And I'm pretty certain that, you know, HCL Amravati will actually be a marquee campus and will be a marquee destination for all their high-end work. And I'm pretty certain that the you know, employees here and the citizens of Andhra Pradesh will not let them down. With this, I'd like to thank them again for their belief and trust in the state of Andhra Pradesh. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Honorable Minister. You talked about leadership, and one of the key takeaways that leaders do and have in HCL, which has taught us, is that wherever we go, we also take a bit of the local culture, assimilate the best part of them into the workplace. I'm sure there is a lot to learn from Vijayawada, and the project Amravati will also carry some of the best local culture, local practices. And much of the benefits, policies that we do for any employees will also have a mark of local culture. So something we have learned is we may be global, but you don't forget the roots. And that has really helped us to also stay firm on the ground. Of course, thanks to the management and thanks to the leader who has showed us the way all these years. And another thing a leader does is also to pick up the local language. So probably in a year to come, when the project is going on, one of the resolutions I have, because a lot of gentlemen from Vijayawada and Guntur, they've been quite teasing me around my Telugu capability. So I am going to also ask for a good Telugu teacher and pick up a bit of Telugu skills. And possibly the next year when we go live, I may say the word of thanks in Telugu. That's probably I'll try. So I think that's important, because we always say we speak English, but there's a lot of Tanglish as well, which comes into our IT, and that's something we will pick up, right? So this is an auspicious day for us, and it's an honor to be here. We have all the leaders from HCL also have assembled. We have just started the journey, and we know there is quite some way to go, but we know we will achieve it, and we will get it.